now let me welcome Nupur Desai. She is a daughter of one of the leading independent financial advisor, Vibhash Desai, having some 250 crore of mutual fund and PMS AUM. Okay, so I request Nupur to take over and share your success story.
Thank you, sir. Hello, everybody can hear me?
Yes.
Hi friends, good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, I guess good afternoon now. This is my company. My company's name is VND Wealth Managers Private Limited. My name is Nupur Desai and I'm a CFP certified professional. I'll give you a brief introduction about my company. This company has been, it's a dream baby of my father's. My father started this company in 2007. And we do retail investment for individual clients. We do gold-based investment for our retail clients. My father was a very dynamic, cyclic businessman. He never wanted to be in a job. He never wanted a boss over him. He always wanted to be his own boss. So he kept trying on different businesses. He went for plastic manufacturing. We went for MBA. A lot of you might have heard MBA. Then eventually in 2007, he met a person who introduced us to mutual funds and financial planning, basic financial planning. And since he was there in share market since a long time, since about 20 years now, he thought that this business would really do good for himself and for his clients or for his friends or for his relatives. So that is how VND Wealth Managers Private Limited came into existence. And since it is a long-term process and we are dealing with people's money, he told me that, Nupur, I would need a second line entrepreneur. I would need a second line, second generation entrepreneur to take care of my clients who have invested with me for a very long time. I myself is a BSc chemistry. I'm from science background. Before joining this business, I had no clue about finances. I hated maths. I did not like calculations and everything. So I had my own apprehensions. I asked my father, I am not good in maths, I don't like maths, and you're giving me one thing that I don't like, that is finance. He told me, finance is not about maths, don't worry. You learn CFP, get enrolled in a certified financial planning course, you get to know what financial planning is, what you will be doing, how you will be making a difference in clients' life. And that is how he convinced me to leave my pure science line and come into financial planning with him. That is my, we deal into equity, debt, insurance, and real estate. These are mission, vision, and values for my company. Our mission is to help our clients become financially independent and secure. Our mission is to preserve their wealth, which they already have made. And our mission is to help them achieve all their financial goals. That is the mission, that is what we do for our clients. Our vision is we aspire to make our 1,000 plus client base dollar millionaires by 2030. Dollar millionaires means each client will have 100 crore plus HNI AUM. Each client of mine will be an HNI. This is our aspiration, this is our vision for our company. And values of course include integrity. We give them a real picture to our clients. We give them a proper real financial picture for them. Our communication is fair and authentic. We give honest advice and proper guidance. Struggles, challenges, and achievements. Initially, when my father started the business in 2007, there were a lot of financial players already in the market, like India Infoline, like Motilal, Oswal itself, and Anand Rathi, and all these financial players were already there present. So initially, we found it difficult that people were not trusting us with their money. They used to ask us, "Aapke paas kya education hai? Aapke paas license hai? Ye sab karne ke liye? Aapko hum kaise trust kar de?" And all those things we faced initially. But as and when time passed, they started gaining trust. If out of their XYZ corpus that they have, they didn't give us everything of it, they gave us 1%, sometimes 2%. And we were happy to do financial planning for them and receive as much amount they are comfortable to give us in the start. That was one of our initial struggle. Then our products came into picture and people have had bad experiences in their with finances earlier. They were not ready to believe in equity. In any other products apart from traditional products. They always wanted safe FDs and safe products and insurance policies and products like that. That was another hurdle that we faced. There was no goal-based planning. In the market, nobody hand-holded a client to do any kind of goal-based planning. People just used to push products. Somebody who's looking for investment and used to come for investment, people used to just push products to finish their target. So they did not know the importance of goal-based planning and competing with established players, like I said. After we started our business, our challenges included professional management. Because this is a customer-oriented business, you need to have a proper customer service. because your clients are trusting you with their money, they will have a lot of questions. Even after the deal is done, the whole process is completed, they will have a lot of questions. So you need to professionally give them customer service, you need to professionally manage and train your employees. So these are the challenges which we still face today. We are working on it and going about it, but we still face challenges like this today. And brand building. We are in the process of making a brand of VND Wealth Managers Private Limited. Achievements include, over the years, people started gaining trust. Over the years, they came to know that we are giving genuine advice. Their portfolio is doing fine. Over the years, they realized that a goal-based financial planning is important for their growth, for their financial security. So they became very happy and satisfied with us. They recommended their friends and their colleagues to us as well. We developed good interpersonal relationships with them. And that is how we also achieved the third highest net equity sales in NJ. NJ is the portal that we are associated with for technological support. These were the achievements which we gained over the years. Brand building and innovations. A new innovative approach that we chose, that rarely anybody is doing in the market. I wouldn't say nobody is doing, there are people who are doing it. But rarely is time frame and goal-based planning. I will explain further in the slide what goal-based planning is. We used to sit down with the client. We used to ask him, do you guys have any financial goals? They used to mostly tell us, no, I don't have any financial goals. Do I need to plan my financial goals? We used to tell them yes, and then we used to handhold them to analyze their own financial goals. And we used to give time to their financial goals, and depending on the time frame and the goal, we used to do investment. We expanded the technology, we gave online access to our clients, we started bringing clients from other countries because the process went online, we kept going paperless as the days progressed. We published our logos in newsletters, on stalls, we did sponsorship. This was a basic brand building process that we did. We made Mr. Vibhash Desai the brand face of the company. Any company needs a brand face, it needs a voice. Along with the logo, it needs a voice and a face also. So my father was made the brand face of the company. We started shows on financial planning on social media, on FM radio, on Facebook, on Instagram. And we conducted training sessions for men and women. Everybody these days, since finance is an upcoming sector and money matters, so people are involved, people are interested to learn about their finances. People are interested to know what are different products available, what are different avenues. So we started an exclusive training session for laymen, from people who are from different fields who got no clue about finances. We started conducting training sessions for them. We started inviting them over. We started giving them basic financial explanations. We started explaining about the products. We started explaining what, how much to spend, how much to earn, how much to save, what are the rules that are applicable for the same. Our future goals include, like I already said, we want to make our 1,000 plus client, we aspire to make our 1,000 plus client base dollar millionaires. We also want to expand financial trainings for homemakers. Homemakers are the housewives who at times have no idea where the finances are. If something has to happen to the husband or to the earning member of the family, they are always lost what to do, how to go about. So we plan to bring in homemakers. We plan to train students also, right from the beginning. Before they go out in the world for earning and in their professional jobs, we want to train them into how and how much to expenses, how much to save, and why saving is so important. And small business owners, etc. We want to educate individuals on goal-based planning, earning to expense ratio, savings and investment. This is our motto of my company. In investments, why is more important than how. Why over here is your financial goals, and how over here is where to invest, how to invest, kahan dalna hai, kitna kya dalna hai, all that is how. So in investment, why is more important than how. You decide on the why. We always handhold our clients like you guys, that you decide on the why, and let us the pain of how be on us. We will take care of the how. So this is the motto. In investment, why is more important than how. You decide the why, and let us take care of the how. Since I was from chemistry and science background, I had no clue about finances. So my father advised me to go for a certified financial planner certificate. Because since I'm young, I was also asked, when I used to approach clients, I was also asked, do you have any knowledge? Do you have any education in it? How are you coming here and talking about my money? How are you going to help make me my money, which I have earned? You will tell me how to increase my money that I have earned. And all these questions I used to get. So my father advised me to go for a certified financial planner so that clients' basic trust in me is made. Clients trust me, the basic trust is there. you need to be educated enough to guide people's money. Continuous education is very important. Becoming a CFP and getting a certificate, the process doesn't stop over there. You have to go year on year, you have to attend points, and you have to keep doing continuous education. So this is also one added benefit, because it is a very vast industry and it is a very versatile industry as well. So it is important to go for continuous education as well. So I decided to go for certified financial planner. Why Keyur sir? I got introduced, one of my teammates had also done certification with Keyur sir, so that's how I got introduced to Keyur sir. And in my overall experience till now, what I have found is he's the best coach available. The results will be guaranteed provided you follow his instructions, provided you put the number of practice hours that he's told you, provided you do the homework like how he's asked you to do. The results are guaranteed, you will pass, you can take my word for that. His explanation and everything is very simple, systematic, the five-step process is magical and it really works. Outstanding and comprehensive study material, 200 hours of non-repetitive study material. You will not get repetitive questions or repetitive case studies. Up to 200 hours, non-repetitive case studies and questions are available. Best results guarantees, always available for queries, meetings, discussions, seminars, conference. And personal and practical approach will also help studying with Keyur. His simple step-by-step process will be helpful in personal life as well as in your professional life. That is my Keyur sir. Our unique selling points include client acquisition. We never entertain any individual. If a couple is there, if an individual is married, then we don't entertain them alone. If the husband has come, we send him back, we ask him to bring his wife along, and we give explanation to both of them compulsorily. If the wife has come, then we send her back and we tell her to bring her husband along, and then compulsorily we give explanation to the couple. Because it is very important in a family that both the person in a couple should be knowing the whereabouts and finances of the family. That is one way we are unique. We do easy explanations. Our financial plans are very easy, very comprehensible. What we are trying to explain to the clients, they understand very easily and they are convinced. Hence they are convinced. We do not promote or sell any particular product just for commission basis. Since we are independent financial advisors, we are not associated with any one company or any one product. So we give or we pitch only those products to clients which are important for them. No investment done without goal mapping of the client and customer's individual planning for everybody. And client retention, we are regular, we give proper customer service, we are trying to become as professional as possible. We give regular market updates, regular customer updates. If there are any changes which have been developed in the financial industry, we update our client regarding the same. And we explain them what that will impact on their, what will that be the impact of that on their portfolio. Since I've told a lot of goal-based planning, I'll give a small example of what goal-based planning is and how to go about it. So I have a question for you guys. What are some of the non-discretional goals of an individual's lifetime? Non-discretional goals are those goals aane hi wale hain aapke life mein. If you have a kid, bachche ka education aane hi wala hai. If you have a kid, uska marriage aane hi wala hai. Aap earning ho, aap bhi 60 years ke honge to aap retire hone hi wale ho. So basic non-discretional goals of a person's life are child education, child marriage, retirement, buying own first basic home and business contingency for business owners. So to explain you one of these goals, let me ask you, what is an average age when a child needs higher education? 18 child need to go for graduation. At the age of 21, he needs to go for higher education, which is M.Tech, MBA, foreign studies, etc. So can you guys tell me what is the cost of higher education degree in engineering or in foreign studies today? 10 to 15 lakhs average for foreign studies? 25 lakhs per annum, exactly. Engineering cost, post-graduation engineering cost today is, let's consider on an average, 10 lakhs, medical 30 lakhs and foreign studies 40 lakhs. So in this case study, your child is 3 years old. The child will need a higher education at a 21 years of age. Today the child is 3 years old. So he has another 17 years for higher education. Can you now tell me what will be the cost of education after 17 years when he will actually be 21 years of age, when he will actually need the money? Including, assuming the inflation 6%. Any idea?
80 lakhs for the foreign education.
80 lakhs for the foreign education. Okay, anybody for engineering and medical?
18 lakhs for Engineering.
Engineering 27 lakhs, medical 80 lakhs, and foreign studies 1 crore. Depending on the state, that depending on the country. Depending on the country that you get, agar US hai, agar Canada hai, agar Dubai hai, depending on alag-alag currency ke hisab se, on an average we've considered 1 crore. And depending on the post and the state that you get, engineering 27 lakhs and medical 80 lakhs. So this becomes one financial goal of a client. 17 years down the line, uska bachcha jab higher education ke age ka hoga, uske paas isme se itna paisa hona chahiye jama. Kyunki bachcha puchega, papa, main to higher education ke liye jana hai, kya hai aapke paas? Now let us consider an average age when the person retires. Average age when the person retires.
60, 80.
What is an average monthly household expense? An average regular Mumbai household, how much is the monthly expense to run the house, kitchen, ye wo, facility? 35, 40. Let us consider 20,000 rupees per month. An average basic household living, one couple living in the house. Let's consider 20,000 per month. Now, how much, the retirement age is 60, how much corpus do you guys think he will need while he retires? Assuming his current age is 28 years, his retirement is 60 years, his life expectancy 85 years. 60 years pe wo retire hoga, 25 years ki aur life uske paas baki hai. Kaam usne kar diya, aaj uska age hai 28 years. 60 years pe wo retire hoga, 25 years tak wo aur jiyega. Inflation 6% and post-retirement 7%. Anybody whose monthly average household expense is 20,000 per month will need 1,30,000 per month from the day he retires. Agar wo 31st December ko retire hua hai, 1st January ko uske account mein 1,30,000 hona chahiye to cut through that month. Because inflation will still consider only 6% and average monthly household expense will consider only 20,000. Aap log 30,000, 40,000, 50,000 depending and so on bol rahe the. A 20,000 monthly household expense guy will need 1,30,000 per month and his retirement corpus, his retirement kitty should be 3 crore 50 lakhs at least to make him survive financially independently for 25 years. Agar 85, wo bhi minus the medical expense. Agar uska accident ho gaya, kuch bimari a gaya, to all that is different. Ye sirf ghar chalane ke liye uske paise hain. 25 years ke liye, agar 90 years tak jee raha, then we need more than that. But 85 years tak if he is living, his retirement kitty should be 3 crore 50 lakhs at the age of 60 when he's retiring today in my account. So that I can live my 21st year, 25 years happily. This is what the slide says. Now how to create the retirement corpus? On an average, can anybody tell me, ek household kitna save kar sakta hai? Husband, wife mila ke, ya husband mila ke, ya however. How much can an average household save? Ek mahine mein.
5,000,
10,000, okay. 10,000 a month, 15,000 a month, 20,000 a month, and so on, depending on the income and depending on the expenses. Now, let us assume that Mr. X is 28 years old right now, and he has come to me for his retirement planning, and he has 10,000 investment corpus a month. He's come and told me ki mere paas 10,000 hai, mera retirement corpus karna hai, meko 3 CR, 3.5 CR, mere paas 10,000 hai abhi save karne ke liye. But since mere paas 10,000 hi hai, mujhe koi risk nahi lena. मुझे एकदम सेफ प्रोडक्ट में डालना है. सो ही सेड मुझे एक सेफ प्रोडक्ट जो 6% अश्योर्ड रिटर्न्स देगा, मुझे उसमें ही डालना है. दैट्स व्हाट ही इज टेलिंग मी. सो देन आई टोल्ड हिम दैट चलो ठीक है, आपके पास 10,000 रुपीज पर मंथ है इन्वेस्टमेंट के लिए और आपके पास 32 इयर्स है रिटायरमेंट को, आपका प्रोडक्ट आपके हिसाब से 6% वाले सेफ रिटर्न्स में हम डालते हैं. अभी अपन डायरेक्ट स्किप फॉरवर्ड करते हैं आपके रिटायरमेंट एज पे. लेट्स सी, आपने 10,000 एवरी मंथ डाला फॉर 32 इयर्स इन अ सेफ प्रोडक्ट गिविंग 6% रिटर्न और आज आपका रिटायरमेंट डे है, तो आपका किटी कितना होगा? 1 crore 10 lakhs ओनली. ही विल फॉल शॉर्ट ऑफ हिज फंड्स. बच्चों पे डिपेंड करना पड़ेगा रिटायरमेंट पे, घर मॉर्गेज करना पड़ेगा, गाँव जाना पड़ेगा, बिजनेस सेल करना पड़ेगा, ये सब करना पड़ेगा. अगर आप 10,000 पर मंथ इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हो एक 6% के प्रोडक्ट में, तो दो तीन ऑप्शन है आपके पास. या तो आप 10,000 से बढ़ा दो अगर आपको सेफ रिटर्न चाहिए तो, या तो हम प्रोडक्ट चेंज करते हैं जिसमें एक्सपेक्टेड रिटर्न थोड़ा बेटर हो. तो इसे 10,000 तो मैं नहीं बढ़ा सकता बिकॉज 10,000 मेरा सैलरी इतना है, 20,000 खर्चा में होता है, 10,000 बचता है मेरा. सो लेट्स से ही देन आई टेल हिम दैट देयर आर प्रोडक्ट्स इन द मार्केट व्हिच विल गिव यू एक्सपेक्टेड रिटर्न्स ऑफ अबाउट 12%. लेट्स से आपका ही 10,000 रुपीज अगर मैं इन्वेस्ट करूँ एक ऐसे प्रोडक्ट में विच गिव्स एक्सपेक्टेड रिटर्न्स ऑफ 12%, तो आपका होगा 54 crore rupees. Which means usko chahiye 3.5 lakh par hoga uska 4 lakh. बचे हुए 50 लाख का वो अपने बच्चों को गिफ्ट दे सकता है, उसकी ग्रैंड चिल्ड्रन का एजुकेशन स्पॉन्सर कर सकता है, व्हाटएवर ही विशेस टू डू, टूर पे जा सकता है, एक्सक्यूज मी सॉरी, टूर पे जा सकता है, एनीथिंग दैट ही विशेस टू डू. दैट्स व्हेन ही अंडरस्टूड. अच्छा, सो वी पुट इन अ प्रोडक्ट व्हिच गिव्स एक्सपेक्टेड रिटर्न्स 12 15 18 तो मेरा तो अपना 10,000 में भी काम चल जाएगा और मेरा रिटायरमेंट का गोल सॉल्व हो जाएगा. दैट्स व्हाट आई एक्सप्लेन टू हिम, ही अंडरस्टूड, ही गॉट द कॉन्सेप्ट. So the basic difference between a product which is giving 6% assured returns and a product which is giving 12% expected returns is, first, retirement corpus, retirement goal will be fulfilled comfortably. Unke paas jitna paisa tha, utne amount mein. Second, low risk, low return, ye rule toh we know, calculative risk and good return. A product which is expected to give 12% is a product whose risk is calculated. It is not random or it is not high risk. It's a calculated proper call. And he can enjoy his retirement. Usko retirement ke baad kaam wagera nahi karna padega. He's better. Better the strategy, better the return, better the money needed. This is what we do for our clients. Financial goal based planning. We jot down their financial goals. We help them understand ki inflation impact kabhi hoga when the goal comes. And aaj se kitna investment aapko chalu karna padega to achieve that goal. So these are the principles to create wealth. Start saving early. अभी 10,000 per month SIP उसका काम कर गया, investment काम कर गया, because he was 28 years old and he had 32 years to invest in a product which gives 12% return. So starting early is a major principle. Second is saving in the right asset class. Asset class schemes like 6% is for, let's say, FD, where they get assured returns, and we change the asset class to an expected 12%, which made a huge impact on his retirement corpus. And save regularly. To explain this slide, there is a small example. Let us consider two colleagues, Ram and Shyam. Ram is 25 years old and Shyam is 40 years old. Both of them are supposed to be retired at 60 years of age. Now, 25-year-old Ram has 35 years ahead of him to do his investments. And 40-year-old Shyam has 20 years ahead of him to do his investment. Now, Ram has started by rupees 5,000 investing in monthly SIP. SIP is an equity-oriented product. Every month he is investing only 5,000 because that is his capacity. That is what we have suggested because he's told us that 5,000 is his thing. And Shyam, being an elderly gentleman, has a little more capacity, so his investment is 10,000. But total investment for 35 years, 5,000 is 21 lakh, and for 20 years, 10,000 is 24 lakh. Which means Shyam has invested more in amount also, and his corpus, hence his corpus is more invested, and Ram has invested less in amount, and his investment amount is also 21 lakh. But the difference over here is the time that they have invested for. Since Ram has invested for 35 years, his total corpus came to 5.71 crore rupees because he got a total of 35 years to invest. Whereas Shyam has invested more amount, his investment cushion money is also more, but his time was less, only 20 years, so he got only 1.3 crore as investment. Though he has put in more amount and he's invested more corpus. This is the magic of starting early. The earlier you start, the more your money gets cumulatively added. The more it gains cumulative returns, which is the benefit of starting early. Like Einstein has said, compounding is eighth wonder of the world. Give time to your compounding and you'll see the eighth wonder of the world. Selecting the right asset class, it is a simple change in an investment product will help you attend your financial goal very easily and save regularly. Saving regularly means a monthly disciplined active saving regularly will help you reap the benefits of a down market also and of a high market also. Jabhi market down hai, tabhi aapko units zyada milenge, jabhi market upar hai, tabhi aapko units kam milenge. But eventually dono ko mila ke average impact will be good only. That is why a disciplined systematic investment over a longer period of time will really create wealth for you. So the takeaways from my presentation is goal-based planning, give time to your investments, be disciplined and stick to your investments. Asset allocation is important and wealth creation is easy. It's not that as difficult as everybody thinks it is. So any questions? Thank you guys. Any questions, anybody?
Any questions? There's one.
Yeah.
as per your business profile, okay, why are you working as a sub-broker?
We are not working as a sub-broker, we are working as independent financial advisor. We have
you told me you are using the NJ platform.
Yeah, we are using the NJ partners to NJ.
That means you are the sub-broker.
Yeah, sub-broker, but sub-broker as an NJ we are using because we are routing our products and investment through NJ. NJ is a portal which helps independent financial advisors to easily route their products. You got it? कैसे समझाऊँ मैं टैग आ जाता है सब ब्रोकर का पर टेक्निकल सपोर्ट हमको एनजे जो देता है कि
once you building the brand building you are talking about the brand building all that time it is not affecting you the brand
it is not affecting us okay. All our clients know when they open their online portal they can see एनजे because they have to be clear कि हम VND Wealth तो हैं पर हम invest एनजे के थ्रू जा रहे हैं just investment portal is एनजे तो छोटा सा ऑनलाइन अकाउंट में उनका राइट हैंड साइड पे छोटा सा एनजे आता है जो हम लोगों ने पहले ही क्लियर कर दिया क्वेश्चंस आते हैं एनजे क्या है तो फिर वीएनडी क्या है ये वो तो हम क्लाइंट को एक्सप्लेन कर देते हैं एनजे इज जस्ट अ पोर्टल जिसके थ्रू आपके प्रोडक्ट्स जाएंगे अदरवाइज वी विल बी मैनेजिंग वी विल बी ऑब्जर्विंग एंड वी विल बी अ पर्सन हू यू हैव टू कम टू अगर कुछ डाउट्स है अगर कुछ जानना है अराइज कर सकते सो ब्रांड बन रहा है वीएनडी वेल्थ का फेस है मेरे फादर का ही बट पोर्टल है सिर्फ एनजे का जो हम क्लाइंट को एक्सप्लेन कर देते हैं इन केस दे हैव एनी डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग मोस्ट ऑफ द क्लाइंट्स डोंट हैव डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग एनजे इन केस इफ देयर आर सम That is how we take
it.
That
is how we handle it. Okay. Thank you. I hope I answered. Any other relevant question reference to presentation? So tell me what are your key learning? Huh?
Thank you. So I forgot for let's have a loud clap.
What are your key learnings from this presentation? What are your key learnings?
Systematic approach.
Okay, systematic approach. Okay.
Start early.
Okay. So you have to save early and you have to increase your investment every month.
Goal-based approach.
Goal-based financial planning. Okay.
Easy explanation. Okay. Save regularly.
Okay, but as an independent financial advisor, or mutual fund distributor, what are the key learnings? How, what you are likely to implement from the Nupur, from the tomorrow? Yes.
Why is important that how part will be taken care for?
Okay, very good. So why is more important than the how? What you said? Another someone?
Technology support.
Technological support is required. Okay.
Consulting or counseling in couple, not individually or
okay.
Single person.
Okay. So there is one more important that instead of having the counseling with the only one member of the family, either male member or female, you ask to come together. So chances that कहीं ना कहीं और ज़्यादा seriousness आएगी क्योंकि आप कहीं ना कहीं extra कुछ terms and conditions डालेंगे तो initially आपको लगेगा उसे business कम हो सकता है but आगे जाके इसका benefit क्या मिलेगा business will increase more. Yes, Nada. Okay.
So that they understand what we are trying to explain them and explain them their goals.
Okay, so we have to explain in a basic manner. Okay, so now we have completed three presentations. Me, second, Ankit Savla, third, Nupur. So now we have a quick break for tea coffee. So I request you take a 15 minutes time. Finish off your break, tea break, okay? Refreshment, any mobile call you have got, okay? Miss call. And we'll come back at sharp 12 o'clock. And after 12 o'clock, we have a presentation from Ashish Somaya, sir.